Hi kids, I'd like to welcome you to the Kids Connect online for May 30th. Now, I also want to begin by apologizing because last week on May 23rd, we were unable to put the Kids Connect online due to technical difficulties. But first of all, just to get that out, this is the last Kids Connect online that we'll be putting out, at least for the time being. If things change in the future and we need to go to remote, we will go back to it. But until that time, we are beginning in-person Kids Connect ministry full force, meeting just like normal, and everything will be normal, and I'm looking forward to that. I'd also like to remind you that when we come to church and we have our Kids Connect, your parents can come as well, and there's going to be no limitations on the capacity for our crowd and no requirements for those adults who've been vaccinated to wear a mask or socially distance. And so this is a good time for families to start coming back, and I encourage you to do that. And you know, later I'm going to talk a little bit more about our summer VBS, Vacation Bible Spectacular, but that's going to be normal this year as well. So things are looking up, and I just want to praise God for all the good things He's done for us. And let's start our time together with a song, and then we're going to go into the review question for the last week that we had at KC Online. I'll talk to you guys at the end of things. I hope that you're having a good week. Welcome.
In the beginning was the Word.
In the beginning was the Word.
And the Word was with God.
The Word was with God.
And the Word was God.
The Word was God.
He was with God in the beginning.
John 1:1-2.
In the beginning was the Word, was the Word.
In the beginning was the Word, was the Word.
And the Word was with God.
And the Word was with God.
And the Word was with God.
And the Word was
Hey there, I'm Pastor Brian, and it's time for Questions from Kids. Ashley from Burlington, Wisconsin asks,
how do I know if I'm being tempted?
You know, Ashley, before I answer your question, let me just talk about what temptation is, just so we can make sure we all are on the same page with that. In today's Bible story, we see that Jesus was tempted, but we know that Jesus never sinned. So that proves to us that there's nothing wrong with being tempted. It's not a sin to be tempted. Let's be clear about that. The sin occurs when we give in to temptation. Notice that's what Jesus did not do. Satan tempted him, but Jesus did not go into that temptation and follow through. He said no, and he didn't act on that temptation. So for us, what we want to do is recognize when we're tempted, like you're asking about today, and then figure out how we can resist temptation. So how do we know we're being tempted? Well, there are a couple things. One, we recognize that something within us is desiring us to go away from God's word instead of going toward him and obey his word. There's something within us, either because of an external, the world around us, or just the selfishness of our hearts, our own desires, that we want to either do what we know the word of God says we do not do, or we don't want to do what the word of God says we should do. Either of those are temptations to disobey God, to not obey him fully. And so we just want to be careful that we recognize when we're having these thoughts, when our hearts are moving in us in those directions, and we recognize those are not of God, those are of the world, those are of sin. And so we want to fight against that. So how can you fight against temptation? Well, there are a couple things you can do. The first thing you can do is remember the word of God. Again, this is how we test everything. And so if you desire to do something that's not in the word of God that goes against it, you know it's wrong. And so you can fight against that. You can share with other believers. Have somebody hold you accountable. Go to them and say, hey, something within me, I just want to disobey God. I want something that's not in line with his word. Will you pray with me? And that's the third thing you do. You can pray to God. Ask God to help you. Ask God to reveal that what you desire is not the best for you. Ask him to help change your heart so that you want only what he wants, only what is best for you truly, because it's what is his will. So I got a question back for you. What are some strategies you use to fight temptation?
His ministry had begun. He traveled around preaching about God and telling people to turn away from their sins. People started talking about Jesus and the things he was teaching. They were interested in what Jesus had to say. Large crowds followed Jesus around and listened to him teach. One day, Jesus was walking along the Sea of Galilee. He saw two brothers, Simon, who was called Peter, and Andrew. Peter and Andrew were fishermen. Jesus called out to them, "Follow me, and I will teach you to fish for people." Right away, Peter and Andrew dropped their nets and followed Jesus. Later, he saw two more brothers. Their names were James and John. They were in a boat, fixing nets with their father, Zebedee. Jesus called out to them, and right away they got up, left their father and the boat, and followed Jesus. Jesus went on and saw a man named Matthew, who was also called Levi. Matthew was sitting at the tax office. Matthew was a tax collector. Many people didn't like tax collectors because tax collectors were unfair. Jesus called out to him, "Follow me." So Matthew got up, left everything behind, and followed Jesus. Matthew had a big feast for Jesus at his house. Many tax collectors and sinners came to eat with Jesus and his disciples. The religious leaders saw this, and they didn't think Jesus should be friends with people who did wrong things. They complain to the disciples, "Why does your teacher eat and drink with tax collectors and sinners?" Jesus heard the religious leaders and said, "People who are healthy don't need a doctor, but people who are sick do. I did not come to invite good people. I came to invite sinners to turn back to God." Later, Jesus gathered his followers together and chose 12 of them to be his disciples. Jesus's apostles would work closely with Jesus and would go out to tell others about him. These are the men Jesus chose: Simon, who was called Peter, Simon's brother Andrew, James and John, who were called the Sons of Thunder, Philip and Bartholomew, Matthew and Thomas, James and the son of Alphaeus, Thaddeus, Simon the Zealot, and Judas Iscariot. Jesus came to earth to show what God is like and to save people from their sins. This is great news. Jesus told his disciples to tell others about him, and we are Jesus' disciples when we trust in him. Everyone in the world needs to hear the good news about Jesus.
Beloved of the Father, you were born into this world, living in our limitations and our hurt. The promise of a healing Savior, fully God and fully man, the sacrifice for all, the spotless Lamb. The great I Am redeemed us with his outstretched.
I hope you've enjoyed our time together, and I'm getting ready to close in a word of prayer. but I do want to make a couple of more announcements. First of all, I would like to remind you that our annual Vacation Bible Spectacular will be this summer, August 9th, 10th, 11th, and 12th. And all children from kindergarten through fifth grade are asked to participate. It's going to be a lot of fun. This year's theme is Concrete and Cranes, and we will have a blast. I hope that you choose to come. Also, after prayer, stay tuned because there will be a discussion question for you and your family to talk about. And I know that it will be one that y'all will enjoy. Let's pray. Dear Heavenly Father, I thank you for this week. I thank you for the things that we've learned today. I pray you would bless each one of us. Keep us safe until next week when we see each other again. I want to thank you, Lord, that you've been working throughout this year of COVID in Kids Connect. And I thank you as we look to end the online part and go back to fully in person. I just pray that you would bless us immensely. In Jesus' name, amen. Talk to you guys next week.